For today's video, I bought a Dell XPS desktop with an RTX 3070 in it that cost a surprisingly reasonable amount of money, which weirdly means that buying a Dell pre-built may be one of the most reliable ways at the moment to get your hands on a new RTX 3070, aside from like challenging scalpers to dance battles in the street or whatever. But just because it's a reliable way to do it, does it mean that you should actually go through with it? Before we answer that question, we have a sponsor for today's video that helped me pay for this pre-built. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace, a brilliant way to get your own website up and running, even if you have no web design experience. Squarespace has a whole library of templates which are trendier than a vegan ice cream shop, and they're an easy starting point for a professional looking website. Modifying these templates to fit your need is so easy that even I could do it. Squarespace also has a whole host of other features, like mobile optimized websites so that your site will look good regardless of what device people are using it on. And Squarespace has really powerful e-commerce features so that you can become the next finger paint selling tycoon. On top of that, you can optimize the SEO of your finger paint sales so that you don't get lost in the Googles. If that sounds good to you, head over to squarespace.com for a free trial. And once you're done setting up your new site and you want to go live, use squarespace/David to get 10% off your first website purchase or domain purchase. Thank you again, Squarespace, for sponsoring today's video. Now, before we get into the nitty-gritty unboxing and laughing at a terrible pre-built bit of the video, let me just walk you through the actual process of buying it on Dell's website. Now, it was pretty straightforward. I just spec'd the system that I wanted, and it actually had an option for dual-channel versus single-channel RAM, which I very excitedly selected, and it means that this may be the first pre-built that I've looked at that actually came with dual-channel, so that's pretty big. But other than that, it had a 3070 in it with a 10700, a 500GB NVMe SSD with a terabyte hard drive. And that whole system cost the equivalent of about $1,500, which is way better than you can do on the open market at the moment. So yeah, it's not too bad considering what you get. I am really excited to see what version of the RTX 3070 it comes with. Hopefully it's not some like war crime blower cooler. But when I finally placed the order, I had an issue with my payment method, which meant that I had to spend an hour and a half with a Dell representative on their online chat service thing or whatever, which was really frustrating. Although in all fairness, it wasn't the chat representative's fault that it took so long. They were very friendly and helpful, it's just because my bank's weird with addresses linked to payment methods or whatever. So yeah, it wasn't their fault, but it was still pretty frustrating. Although it was a much better experience than Linus recently had, which basically was borderline extortionary. So bear that in mind. So with that, let's open up this system and have a look at it. It's so little, it's way smaller than I was expecting. I mean, compared to the obscene size that the Alienware box was, for example, this is actually quite a breath of fresh air. I'm excited to get in here. It's the moment of truth, let's get in here. In standard Dell fashion, you have just like a big cardboard thing with all of your accessories and stuff in it. So in this accessory pouch, we have e-waste peripherals, as is tradition. These do seem like alpha e-waste peripherals though. That is some plasticky garbage in there. We've got a power cable, and then the keyboard also just looks like landfill fodder. And then in here, we have the Dell XPS with the same awesome packing foam that they use in the Alienware system. So that's pretty good. That's already a letdown. I know that it's not a gaming system, but does it really have to look like something that an accounting firm uses to do like mid-tier Excel on? And here it is in all its glory. Now, if you can somehow manage to get over the animalistic lust that its looks inspire, then actually, it's got a really good front I/O here. Up here, it's got a DVD drive for all of you that still want to get some use out of your friend's box set. Down here, you've got reasonable looking front I/O. This is actually really good. You've got three what looks like USB 3 ports, and then a 3.1 type C port, an SD card slot, and a front headphone jack. That's really good. And then up here, you've got this weird like plastic pattern up the front for airflow. So, you know, it's got some intake action going on.
Yo, I feel like these Dell XPSs look lamer and lamer with every generation.
In terms of the rear I/O, it looks like every OEM pre-built I've pretty much ever seen. So you've got a bunch of USB 3 ports, a couple of USB 2 ports with Ethernet. You've got some audio jacks with display outs, which you're not going to use on this system because we've got the 3070 in here. I'm really excited to see what variant of the car it's in here. And then finally down here, we have the power supply, which is as confidence inspiring as a Soviet era nuclear power plant operator. But with that, let's open it up and see what it looks like inside this accountant's wet dream. We've got some captive thumb screws, which that's quite nice. No f***ing way! Okay, this is outrageous. I specifically spec'd 2 8-gig sticks, and look what they gave me! Dell, what the f***? I was so excited to get a pre-built that actually had dual channel in it because I had the option to spec it up, and look what they did! Okay, now that I've taken a moment to cool my jets from the complete outrage, let's have a look at the rest of the interior, which actually looks very familiar. It reminds me a lot of the interior of the Alienware, actually. You've also got this bracket here over the 3070, which actually looks like a really interesting OEM variant. We'll have a closer look at that just now. And then over here, you have the CPU cooler equivalent of like thumbing in a softie. Over here, you've got a hard drive. I can't remember what size that is. And then finally, we have the SSD down here, which is so cute. Look at how little it is.
Ooh, and look at that power delivery.
And then just like with all Dell products, they have airflow on the front pretty much just for the marketing material, because then they just add so much stuff in the back blocking it that it doesn't really do much. But yeah, I'm interested to see the temperatures of this system. And then finally, we have that power supply, which is actually 80 plus platinum rated, which is quite exciting. Its output is rated for 500 watts, which is not the most worrying part. The most worrying part is that it has several 18 amp 12 volt rails, which, assuming that the 3070 is going to run off a single one of those rails, that's not ideal. But other than that, there's not much to talk about in here. So let's get this card out and have a closer look at this 3070.
Oh wow, the card barely fits out.
Hey, that cooler actually looks pretty decent. You can see here that it actually like blows through the top of the card as well. So the actual PCB is just this long. I think this may actually be a reference PCB 3070, which means it's one of only three in the world. In there, there's what looks like four pretty chunky heat pipes, and it's a relatively dense fin array. So it seems as though Dell has learned to upgrade the coolers on their OEM cards, which is a really good sign, because that was a huge issue with most of their products in the past, including the Alienware ones. So with that, let's put this bad boy back in the system, fire it up, and try and somehow get over the disappointment of the single 16 gig stick. Okay, let's fire up this bad boy and see how much PC venereal disease bloatware it comes with. Dell is usually quite a bit better than Acer with that stuff, but it usually still has a reasonable amount of venereal disease on it. There's a bunch of Dell stuff. And then XL, yeah, okay, clearly Dell knows what people are going to use this system for. Then there's like a killer control center. We've got McAfee, which, I mean, I guess that's kind of the only way McAfee can sell any of their products at this point, is by forcing it down people's throat on a pre-build. Down here, we've got some power media stuff, and yeah, again, it's not too bad. Now in here, we can see it's got a 10700, which is a pretty good CPU. Down here, we've got the single 16 gig stick of RAM. And I was so excited to finally get a pre-built that had a proper dual channel RAM configuration, but nope, Dell had to take that away from me. Next up, we've got a terabyte normal hard drive and a 512 gig Samsung NVMe SSD. So with that, let's see how the system handles games with that beast of a graphics card that it's got. It's always the same damn story with these pre-builds, isn't it? When you look at the gaming performance, it's never nearly as good as you'd expect considering the hardware in the system. It's as predictable as the sun setting in the evening and the tides changing over the course of the day at this point. In fact, I'm sure you can all rehearse it with me what the problems are, right? So let's say it together, kids. Because the CPU cooler is poo-poo garbage, it means that the processor doesn't boost very high, and that in combination with the single channel memory means that you lose a lot of gaming performance. So let's have a look at Battlefield 5 running to illustrate this point. You can see that the RTX 3070 is boosting to 1920 MHz, which is good, and the temperatures aren't bad. But the utilization is hovering between 50 and 60%, which means that the graphics card is waiting for the CPU to catch up, which only boosts to about 3.8 GHz, which is not great for a 10700, even a non-K variant. And as is always the case, one of the reasons why the core frequency isn't boosting that high is because it's running hotter than the Earth's mantle. And then again, that in combination with the single channel means that you lose quite a lot of gaming performance. Now, I redid the Battlefield 5 benchmarks at 1440p, and we got the exact same result, which again shows that the CPU memory configuration is holding the graphics card back, even at 1440p, which is pretty crazy. So if Dell actually shipped the system with dual channel, like I specifically asked for, and they used the cooler that they very proudly show in all of the marketing material, the system would have performed quite a lot better than it does at the moment. Which is a shame, because considering the size of Dell, they have the pick of the litter for like new graphics cards, and they're one of the most reliable ways to get your hands on an Ampere graphics card, which now actually has a decent cooler on it. But then they pair it with that thing, which is just, it's just such a shame. Yeah, it would just be so easy to get this thing to be better, but you know, at this point I just sound like a broken record. So yeah, let's finish off the video on that note. Thank you very much for watching. If you liked the video, please like and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this one, and until the next video, bye-bye.